Mel Kotler here, founder of Meetup Zoo, and what I'm going to share with you in this video is the top 10 keys that 99% of organizers don't do, and that's why their meetups don't flourish, and they don't grow, and they don't build that community that can happen if you do these properly. Now, whether you're about to start up a meetup, you're going to want to apply these top 10 keys before you start. And if you've already started a meetup, make sure you implement them immediately into your current meetup. The first key that I'm going to share with you is that you must make your meetup a community. Make your meetup a community. What that means is if you make your meetup too much of a business type of culture, if you make it too much all about your business or about you, and what you want to sell, Meetup will shut you down. As a matter of fact, when they review your Meetup, they won't let it go up. They won't even post it. So you must make sure that it's all about the education that you're teaching. It's all about the community that you want to build, because those are the core values of Meetup. Key number two. Key number two is post a Meetup right away. The moment you launch your Meetup, you want to make sure that there's already an event posted, so there's when people join, they have something to look forward to and they can RSVP right away. So make sure you have a meetup that you can post right away. Key number three, make sure that you post pictures of your event. So after you have your first event, make sure you snap some pictures and you'll be able to take those pictures and post them up on Meetup. That gives you credibility for future members, and that also inspires members that haven't gone to your event to come because they see it's for real. Key number four, get sponsors and accept perks. What that means is that on occasion, as you grow your meetup, you're going to get sponsors that want to sponsor your meetup and give perks, which are benefits to your meetup. These will be outside companies. Now, you want to make sure that these outside companies, when they share these perks or they want to sponsor your meetup, that it fits good with your meetup and that you'll know it brings value to your members. One thing that we do for our clients when we outsource all this entire process is we actually make them a sponsor of their own meetup. So we'll take their business and their business will actually be a sponsor of the meetup so people know that they're connected. Key number five, always form joint ventures and be on the search for affiliates that can help promote your meetup and also market your meetup. So what you can do is you can join other meetups that are in the same type of arena as you that have your perfect member or your perfect client, and you want to make friends with the organizer. Send them an email that's saying, hey, look, you know, you might be able to come speak at my meetup and I may be able to come and speak at your meetup and we can cross promote. So always be looking to form joint venture partners. Key number six. Key number six is always be inviting members from similar groups into your group. That's a key strategy to continually grow your group. So you can find other groups, join them, become a member, and then invite those members into your group saying, hey, look, we have a similar group, we share this, this, and if you're interested, come join our group. Key number seven. Key number seven is if you're serious about growing your meetup and you really want to meet your target market, join other groups and go to them physically. In your area, map out the groups that are doing really successful and go to them. When you go to them, you'll be able to make friends with the organizer, who's most likely a connector in the area, who has an influential group of people, and you'll be able to see what he's doing, the good and the bad, and you'll also be able to meet his members. And his members may be interested in your group as well. Now, you want to make sure that you're congruent and that you have some sort of agreement with the organizer and you make friends and he knows exactly what you're doing. Key number eight. That's to create a group on Facebook and LinkedIn that will be promoting your meetup group. So on Facebook, you can add your friends that are already interested in your area about what you're going to teach, and then direct them specifically to your meetup. You can do the same thing with LinkedIn. And I have doubled and tripled my group just by doing that one key strategy. Key number 9, promote your meetup with video. You can shoot a quick 30 second to a minute video about that month's topic and send it out to the group. Post it on your Facebook, post it on your LinkedIn, and that will actually give your potential members or the potential people thinking about coming, and they'll get to know you a little bit better, and then they'll be able to make the right decision because they'll already feel like they know you through video. And key number 10, that's always be in contact with your members. If they have questions, make sure you're answering their questions. They might ask, oh, is this meetup free? Where's the location? You know, can I bring a friend? Whatever questions they have, you want to make sure that you answer them so they know that someone real and someone who cares is behind that meetup and is taking care of them. And these are the things that we outsource here at Meetup Zoo, because it could end up being a full-time job making sure you're doing all these keys, making sure that you're doing them properly on a daily basis. It could turn out to be a full-time job, and that's why here at Meetup Zoo we have outsourcing packages that will help you outsource all of this so you can focus on your core competency. If you think that this is something that you want, or you want to set up a strategy session, our team is more than happy and willing to discuss that with you. So that's it. Those are the 10 keys. Make sure you follow them like the 10 commandments, because I promise you that they will make the difference in your meetup. Take care, and remember, if you ever want to get a hold of us, you can easily email us at answers@meetupzoo.com. Again, that's answers@meetupzoo.com.